Hey guys, welcome to the channel Rockin' the Country. I'm Don. I'm having a ball with this. I hope you're having a good day. I am. I mean, I love doing these reviews. It's a bit of work, but I mean, there's a reason I do it. I love doing this, and I learn a lot from you guys. I'm doing another Chris LeDoux song, The Ride. And this song was requested by JC, Emma Terry, and Hunter Brett 1983. So this goes out to you. But also I'm doing this kind of in Mike Robertson's honor. He's a subscriber, right? And Mike, a little while back, I don't remember whose video it was. It might have been a Chris LeDoux video, but it was. Because I was, you know, I made the mistake, the sin of confusing bronc riding with bull riding. And you educated me on that in the comments. So I'm doing this in your honor, you know, the bull versus bronc riding to me. And there's a lot to know in this world. And cowboy speak and how it works and bronc riding and bull riding and saddles and all that stuff. I know you want to get 8 seconds up when you're riding a bull. But you know, there's a lot to learn. I'm trying. But this is in your honor too, my friend Mike. And also, let's see, Mad Cow, you won a David Allen Coe's rendition, as did Darlene Perry. But I'm going with Chris LeDoux's because I'm doing like a mini Chris LeDoux marathon here of 3 songs in a row. So, and this is the second of 3. So here we go with Chris LeDoux's The Ride. I'm curious to see what kind of picture he paints.
I was 6 years old, my brother was 10, when July day came running in. Seen a Ferris wheel at the edge of town, so of course we headed on down. Yep. Well, it took us an hour to walk that far, carrying our fortune in a mason jar. It was all pretty sad, a cheap county fair, with a few old rides, but there was ponies there.
You remember that as a kid? I do, man. This is bringing me back to when you're a kid, it's all this wonderment. Everything is new, and then you see like these little rides, like the teacup ride or whatever, which just sort of went around this little track and wove in and out. And you couldn't believe you weren't smashing into the other teacups, you know, that your seat was in. And man, you just loved it. And then the ponies, you'd see a pony and you're like, oh my gosh. And he's bringing me back. I mean, that's what these songs do. Chris is really good at it too, bringing you right into a scene. Here we go.
Well, the ponies stunk and the air was still in that dusty circle behind the Ferris wheel. This old guy smelling a smoking rum swung me up and set me down on one. Well, I'd never rode a horse, but I'd seen it done. Cowboy movies made it look like fun. This old man whispered a few soft words. It was the best advice I ever heard. And sit tall in the saddle, hold your head up high. Keep your eyes fixed where the trail meets the sky. And live like you ain't afraid to die.
Yep, I like that.
And don't be scared. Just enjoy your ride.
Oh, I like that. I like that advice a lot right there. Wow. I love metaphors. I love when they're really well done, whether it's in a book or in a song. And right here, sit tall in the saddle. Just hold your head up. Be who you are in life. Go after it. Don't be afraid to die. That's a big one. Even in my life coaching that I do, it's called life coaching. I don't like that phrase because you don't coach people about life. You could talk about life and let people adopt what parts of it they want to adopt, you know? But not being afraid to die. I think there's the balance to be struck there. If you're 100% not afraid to die, I think that's out of balance. I think you got to have some desire to live, you know what I mean? But then again, if you're like completely afraid to die, then like then there's something wrong there too. You're going to be uptight your whole life and all bound, man. You got to, you know, on a certain level, accept that we're going to die someday. And then, you know, reverse engineer your life with that in mind, you know? Like, the big, beautiful house that you get, well, that's going away sometime. But the hard times are going away sometime, too. You know, like, when we die. Like, theological considerations aside, whatever those are. But all that said, holy cow, I love that, man. I haven't heard anybody say that. I haven't heard anybody say that in any song. Not that I expect to hear it in a song, but don't be afraid to die. I mean, there's a lot to be said about that. And I'll be saying it too, but in another forum. All right, here we go.
I went up a kid with shaking hands, but I came down a full-grown man. It's like he cast some voodoo spell. Things were different for me now, I could tell. 'Cause whenever troubles came wandering in, his rhyme would pop in my head again. Somehow I rode through the needles and nails, brambles and thorns that life entails. And sit tall in the saddle, hold your head up high, keep your eyes fixed where the trail meets the sky. And live like you ain't afraid to die. And don't be scared, just enjoy your ride.
Amen. Enjoy that ride.
Well, I know someday, farther down the road, I'll come to the edge of the great unknown. There'll stand a black horse, riderless, and I'll wonder if I'm ready for this. Well, I'll saddle him up and he'll switch his tail, and I'll tip my hat and bid farewell, and lift my song into the air that I learned at that dusty fair. Sit tall in the saddle, hold your head up high, keep your eyes fixed where the trail meets the sky. And live like you ain't afraid to die.
Yeah, you're gonna ride.
Scared, just enjoy your ride. Nah, don't be scared, just enjoy your ride.
That's like a triple metaphor. Wow, he brought it right back to his bronc riding because he was a professional rodeo guy. And so, wow, he brought it back from not just being a metaphor about life and how to live it, but how to ride. Man, I like this song. There's so much in it. So much in it. But I don't know. Chris LeDoux is such, you know, when you get a guy like Chris LeDoux or like a Jerry Reed who have multiple talents, like phenomenal musicians, phenomenal songwriters. In Jerry Reed's case, a phenomenal guitarist, and just they just bring you in. Like, what is it about folks like that that not only have like the physical talent, but the psychological and emotional talent to make it work for other people? I mean, those are just gifts. And Chris was able to just, Chris LeDoux in this song, just bring you right back to that six-year-old, I think he said six-year-old boy. They walked, it took an hour, you know, down to the county fair, carrying the mason jar full of whatever change a kid would have. And then he got to ride a pony, and this guy who had rum on his breath, in the smell, were the smelly ponies behind, what was the ride, Ferris wheel maybe? You know, and he got up there, and that's when the guy gave him this advice. So, you know, you don't know when your words are impacting people in life either. It could come from the strangest places, you know, or the least expected. Or you don't even know you're necessarily impacting somebody's life when you're saying something to them when they're younger, good or bad, you know. But people are listening, you know. We're all listening. We're all taking stuff in. And we may not acknowledge it. We may not even be nice about it. We may even say we don't want it. But we're hearing it. And it may impact our lives. So hold your head up high and talk with people once in a while anyway. Kids are listening. But what a song. All right. I really did like this song. I mean, it made me think. It brought me back to my childhood when I would go to the fair that we, you know, would come through town. Every area has them. It has the fairs that would come through. And it's just this world of wonderment as a kid. And there's the cotton candy and, you know, the different smells and sounds and people and all that. And that was good stuff. So I'm gonna give this one, I'm giving it a 9.1. Yeah, I just love this song. I love the story in it. The instrumentation was simple and designed to be very simple. No distraction whatsoever from the instrumentation. Nothing that took your mind somewhere else, and even for a second. It was all about the song, the lyrics, the story, the feel, the kid, the advice, grown-up advice, and all that. So 9.1, I'm giving Chris LeDoux's The Ride. I loved it. So JC, Emma Terry, and Hunter Brett 1983, specifically for you. Mike Robertson, thank you again, my friend. I'm sure I'm going to get more education after I post this one. And Mad Cow, that one goes out to you too, even though you wanted Dave and Alan Coe's rendition. Maybe I'll get to that one down the line too. So there it is, guys. All right, hit the subscribe button if you made it this far. And that's it. Have a great day, guys. Keep rocking the country.